Hi everybody, this is Riley here for another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Today I'll be looking at mixed breeding your livebearers within your aquarium. Is it possible? If not, why? Stay with me as I delve a little bit more in this topic. Okay, so when talking about aquarium fish, people tend to, you know, gravitate to livebearers because they have a tendency to say that livebearers are one of the most easier type of fish species to keep within your aquarium. Advent of COVID and more time being spent at home, giving you enough time to, you know, check certain things, research certain things, I have discovered several things, right? Especially when it comes down to fish keeping. One thing I have discovered is that although you have live bears, for example, guppy, molly, swordtail, and most of them belongs to the, you know, the Livebearing line, or should I say, yeah, the Livebearing class of fish, you have categories in which they have to belong to before you can say, okay, then they can actually mix breed. For example, you know, put in guppies with mollies, right? Now, I'm going to be answering several questions, probably about three, really, not really several, three questions. I'm going to be answering whether or not you can actually crossbreed between geniuses, whether or not you can crossbreed between specific type of Livebearing fish, and how do you actually start and actually become successful in that. Okay, so let me first start with the question about the grouping of Livebearers. Now, fish species are normally grouped in family, class, genus, kingdom, and phylum, right? Now, for a fish to be able to mix breed, or should I say to breed, they should come from the same genus. Now, fish like swordtail, I can't pronounce the word, come from a higher order of, it starts with Z, you'll see it down there on the screen, right? Coming from a higher classification, right? Now, that fish, swordtail, cannot interbreed with mollies, and it can interbreed with guppies, right? Because they are from the different genuses, right? I think I'm definitely sure that they can breed guppies. I'm not 100% about the mollies. I haven't really read up that 100%, but I know that they can't breed with guppies, right? So the next question is, how can you actually assure that for example, two different species, because you can have different species, but they're from the same genus, they're from the same kingdom, they're from the same family, they're from the same phylum, right? So how can I get my, let's say, my guppy, my male guppy, or my female guppy, or my guppy fish to breed with, let's say, first thing I would do is to try and see if I can get some virgin males and virgin females. This process is a little bit longer than the other process, and the other process is it's a little bit time consuming to me, but some persons might say it is not, right? The other process is that you will get a male guppy and two or three female molly and place them in the same space, and you know, we check to see after a couple weeks what happened after that. But bear in mind that you know, Livebearers can keep the mint of males for 8 months. You might end up with about 8-9 months before you actually see any works between both of them, meaning like you actually see fries coming from mix between the guppy and the molly, right? So the best way to actually get babies, and you know, you can assure that yes, this happened within a few weeks, if not less than 8 months, is to get a set of fries that are virgin. How do you do this? Whenever the fish actually give birth, you extract probably two or three of the fries. You place them in a separate container in solitude from everybody else, from every other fish that you have. You're not going to know the male or the female until a few weeks time when it starts to grow, and you can actually see the attributes of male and female, right? Okay, and as soon as you can identify that this is a male, this is a female, then now you can actually place them in the same space. I mean, like one guppy male, and normally you use a male, right? You use one male guppy to inseminate the two female mollies. So it's not really advised to use male mollies to impregnate female guppies. It's the other way around. However, the next question is, can I actually do the same with my, let's say, my swordtail and my guppy? And as I said before, probably I'm going to be putting it into perspective. No. And the reason why is that they are from different genus, right? Their swordtail is from a higher genus than guppy. So therefore, it's going to be like an impossible feat trying to actually get both to actually procreate. Now, I think I've answered all three questions, right? So the first question is, yes, you can actually crossbreed Livebearers from different species, but not from different genus, right? You cannot crossbreed, let's say, swordtail and guppy. You can crossbreed and guppies, right? That means you can actually get molly looking a little bit fancy with the tails and with the look. It just look unique, right? Some people might say hybrid. Yeah, probably. Yeah. Right. And also, one of the easier way to actually do this is to try to get the virgins, try to get those fries that have not become, what I call it now, sensitive towards sex, yeah? In the sense that, you know, I have some fries, and the fries, I place them into a different container than all, right? And my fries are now giving me fries. I mean, like one fry, like probably about half inch, can give me probably about two fries. So as early as probably about 2-3 weeks, the fries can actually procreate. So you don't want this type of situation. So you want a virgin, you want a fry that have not produced anything, nor in any state of condition to be impregnated and keeping the mint. I hope that this video was of, you know, value to you. So you can go ahead and try to crossbreed molly and guppies. Point to note, if you have female guppies in the space with the male guppy, you will never ever get the male guppy to impregnate the female molly, right? So for you to actually get the crossbreed between the molly and the guppy fish, you would have to have the three. When I say three, I mean you normally have two females and one male, right? And the one male would be the guppy. You would have those three fish in one space, and you see what happens there. This is Riley here for another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Thank you very much for tuning in. I hope that this video was a great value to you. Catch you next time. Bye bye for now. Peace out.